and welcome to Poltex Tech Lightning. I have the ability to foresee the future. So I have handpicked four features that's coming to Azure this year. So stay tuned. Here we go.
These are the upcoming Azure features we will talk about. First off, the SFTP support for Azure Blob Storage. Then we have Azure Bastion Native Client Support, Virtual Machines Restore Points, and last but not least, the Azure Virtual Network Manager. So, which one do we start with? I have a brilliant idea here. How about we go through this list in chronological order? First off, we have SFTP support for Azure Blob Storage. It now supports, well, it's in public preview, SFTP over object storage in a serverless fashion. No longer do you need to install a virtual machine with an SFTP client in Azure. This service is only available in certain regions at the time of recording. It's, for example, not available in Europe West, but in Europe North and other regions in the world, such as the US, Australia, Canada, and more. Let's immediately jump into a demo to see how it looks like today. First, you need to have opted in for the public preview and created a storage account with SFTP functionality. Here's the storage account I prepared in advance. In the overview, there's a new option you can see here, SFTP. As you see, it's here enabled. On the left-hand side, you will also find a new entry called SFTP. In order to have a somewhat functioning SFTP environment, you need a couple of things. First, we should define a container which is used to upload and store data. You just need to click on the container on the left-hand side. You click on plus container to add one, and now we get to specify a name. So we put in a name, we put it on private to ensure that there will be no anonymous access, and we click on create, and the container is created. Now, we also need to create users because users will need to access this container through SFTP. So you just click on SFTP, click on add local user. So keep in mind, Azure Storage does not support shared access signature, SAS, or Azure Active Directory authentication for connecting with SFTP clients. Instead, SFTP clients, they must either use a password or a secured shell, SSH, private key credential. So, we enter a username, we select SSH password. Next up, we need to set the container permissions. Here we can select the container that we created previously, and now we get to select the permissions this user should have on the container. So these are the options available. Home directory. This is directory or container the user should default to. In this case, we need to enter the /patricksftp container name. Otherwise, you have to specify this in the connection string. So let's create the user, and after that is done, the password is shown. So let's copy that for testing purposes. Here is the user we created, and we see the detail of the connection string. Let us get a terminal up and see if we can SFTP to the directory itself. So have a look here. Now you see we are logged in. So let's upload a file to see if we can put anything on this server. So first off, on my local machine, we will set the local directory, LCD. So here we go, LCD. Okay, now we've set the local directory and it's time to upload a data. I know I have a file called data.xlsx in this directory, so let's upload it. Great, so far so good. Let's see if we can find the data back in the portal. So we click on containers, select our container, and what would we have here? Amazing, the data file we just uploaded through SFTP. As we have seen, SFTP is just awesome, but the service needs to be expanded a little bit in Azure. For example, think about user management. How do you handle users if you have more than 100 or 200, 300 users that you need to import or that needs access to the system. So think about that one carefully. Next up is the Azure Bastion native client support. Using Azure Bastion today, we connect to virtual machines with the Azure client that is built into the portal. This new preview feature enables you to use your native RDP or SSH client running on your workstation to connect to the virtual machine. In order to do this, we first need to enable this in the Bastion host. You can see here the native client support needs to be ticked. Also, we need to have the preview version of Azure Bastion with the standard SKU. Of course, for this to work, the necessary ports towards the VM needs to be open, RDP 3389 and SSH 22. You can then, in order to connect, you can then authenticate it to the Azure CLI and run a command such as here, az network bastion RDP dash dash name. You specify the bastion name, the resource group, and the target resource ID, which is the virtual machine resource ID. So when you run this and the ports are open and it's configured correctly, your native client on your workstation, for example, an RDP client, will then open up and it's like you're connected locally through an RDP client from your workstation. Now, moving on to the next feature, we are seeing something called virtual machine restore points. This new feature in preview allows you to take backups of all the disks attached to a virtual machine. This means you have a full consistent backup of both your OS and application. So the procedure at a very high level is that you first create a restore point collection for the VM. This restore point collection holds all the restore points for a specific virtual machine. Afterwards, you create a virtual machine specific restore point within this restore point collection. And there you can, for example, select disks to exclude should it be necessary. And the first restore point you take is always a full copy of the disks. Next, restore points, they're incremental in order for you to minimize the storage cost in Azure. Have you done that? In order to restore the data, the procedure is that you restore each individual disk from the restore point. Once that is done, you just create a new VM and attach the restored disk. And voila, you have a full VM with OS and application in the state it was before. Our last preview topic today is Azure Virtual Network Manager. Now, this is a management service which allows you to group, configure, deploy, and manage virtual networks globally across subscriptions. Some of the key benefits are you can now centrally manage connectivity and security policies on a global level. It enables communication between spokes in a hub and spoke configuration without an additional layer of complexity. You can easily create global network security rules, which will override the local network security group rules. So, in general, it means that you make configuration and changes to the networking layer in Azure. You can then take this configuration and apply it, for example, to a specific region. So, at the time of recording, this is only available in the US region for preview, but I definitely see this becoming a key component of Azure in the future.
Thank you for watching. I chose these features because I thought they were the most interesting ones that's coming up for this year. Keep in mind that Microsoft, they don't give any public information as to when these will be general available. So, until next time, stay safe and take care. Bye.